Good morning, the students of class 8. Due to the coronavirus, we are starting online teaching to you people from today. So that stay at home and be safe and utilize your valuable time for your studies also. Today, I will start from the history portion, unit 1st. Where, when and how. That is heading, where, when and how. How? India is the 7th largest country in the world. India's neighbors are China, Nepal, Tibet and Bhutan in the north, Pakistan and Afghanistan in the northwest, Myanmar in the east and Bangladesh, an enclave within India. A continent, next heading, a continent of many names. You know that India is known in different names. India has been known by many names during different periods of history, from Aryavarta to Bharatavarsham to Hindustan. The Persians were the first people who used the term India because this land was watered by the river Indus. This river was called Sindhu by the native people. The term Hindu was the twisted form of Sindhu. The Zend Avastha, the holy book of the Parsis, used the term Sapta Sindhu for India. When the Arabs came, they saw the river first and named the country Hind. In ancient Buddhist texts, India was called Jambudvipa. The Greeks called it India based on the river Indus. The Arabs called it Hindustan also. In Sanskrit literature, the country is often called Bharat. The constitution of India uses Hindustan and Bharat, both names, to describe our country. Then points to remember. Number one, India is a subcontinent which is a distinct geographical unit unlike many other countries. Number two, points to remember. Number two, the Persians were the first people who used the term India because this land was watered by the river Indus. Number three, the Zend Avastha, the holy book of the Parsis, used the term Sapta Sindhu for India. Number four, the constitution of India uses Hindustan and Bharat, both names, to describe our country. Homework. Homework for today, learn the given 4 points to remember by heart. By heart.